Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. Gold and silver are ready for a comeback. Are you ready for it? Look at here. Here's where the prices were. Here's where the prices are now. Boom! Sri Lanka, they're making a little bit of a recovery, not by a whole lot, but I think people are starting to realize, you know what, there's, you know, this dream of a vaccine and the market's going crazy and gold and silver going way down, getting smacked down. You know, I think back to reality we are at right now. Just take a look at an article here from CNBC. Now, gold and silver, they've climbed as focus starts to return back to reality. And that reality is loose monetary policy, indeed. And we're going to see that for quite some time here. And so let's get into this article. Gold rose 1% on Tuesday following a sharp slide in the last session as focus returned to the likelihood of a more monetary stimulus to revive a global economy still reeling from the COVID-19 pandemic. Spot gold climbed 1.1%. to $1,881.39 per ounce earlier in the day, while U.S. gold futures were up 1.3% at $1,878. Prices slumped as much as 5.2% on Monday after U.S. drug maker Pfizer said its experimental COVID-19 vaccine was more than 90% effective based off of initial trial results. Central banks are unlikely to change their accommodative stance in the near to medium term, as it will take time for the vaccine deployment and a pickup in growth, inflation, and labor markets, said Lachlan Shaw, head of commodity research at North Australia Bank. So there you go, which that means more money being printed, more stimulus out there, more liquidity into the markets. If inflation expectations pick up as a result of increased economic activity from the vaccine, that should keep a lid on long U.S. real yields and a supporting driver for gold. Gold tends to benefit from widespread stimulus as it is considered a hedge against inflation and currency debasement. While vaccine optimism boosted risk appetite, uncertainties continue to loom over the impact of surging COVID-19 cases in the United States and Europe. And I think that is sort of that dark cloud that's been talked about, you know, is, you know, which is why some governors of states are contemplating some sort of shutdown or hybrid model of shutdowns, or, and especially in the service industries out there. We've already seen it in France and in the United Kingdom. I believe Germany as well, as cases are picking up. But you know what? There's some argument to be made that the places that are shut down, it's not necessarily stopping COVID-19, although it may slow it down somewhat. It certainly is troubling how we're handling this, I think, in some ways. And especially when you hear of restaurants and other service industries completely going out of business, no return whatsoever. You know, and it's just a very sad. And nonetheless, this is the type of thing. And with stimulus that goes out, you know, money that comes from the government that just goes in people's hands or what have you, it's not as effective as money that is actually earned. And it helps the money supply, you know, being circulating money supply from real economic activity. But anyways, the quote continues from Stephen Innes, the chief global market strategist at financial services from firm Axie. I still think we've got more stimulus coming, and the Fed will keep rates low while the vaccine is going to provide reflationary impulse. That's why the markets are still holding on to gold. Dallas Federal Reserve Bank President Robert Kaplan said on Monday that the resurgence of COVID-19 poses a risk to the economy, while Cleveland Fed President Loretta Mester said the Fed's emergency lending programs are still needed. Of course, that's what they're about. They just throw more money at the problem. Silver rose 0.2%, and platinum gained a little bit, and so did palladium. And we also look at this here from Kitco, Jim Wyckoff, and bulls have more work to do as this is the kind of the beginning, but I believe we're going to see the prices continue to go up. You know, Tuesday, they have a way to go to reclaim Monday's strong losses that produced some near-term chart damage. The precious metal bulls are now working to stabilize their markets, made some progress today. December gold futures were last up at 1882.30. And COMEX silver was up about 83 cents to $24.54 an ounce. The gold market Monday saw strong losses that were the worst in 7 years and pushed prices to 3.5 months lows. Gold market bulls on Tuesday were possibly focusing more on the economic impact of record-setting monetary stimulus measures that have been enacted by central banks over the past 6 months. Everywhere, most all the banks are doing it. Central banks out there. Probably more stimulus in the coming months. In fact, I must say it's pretty much a certainty that it's coming. The scenario seems to be inviting some serious price inflation down the road, especially as recovering major world economies shift into higher gears in the coming months. Global stock markets were mostly up overnight, while the U.S. stock indexes were mixed and weaker at midday. The marketplace euphoria is not quite as strong Tuesday, following Monday's news that a successful vaccine has been found for COVID-19. While that news is certainly a bright light in a dark period of the world, the markets on Tuesday are realizing there's still a rough patch that lies ahead in dealing with a pandemic, both for major economies and human health. But it also means that stimulus is going to come as a result of understanding that reality. U.S. Treasury bond and note yields have risen to 8-month highs this week on the prospects of a solid U.S. economic recovery in 2021. The yield on the benchmark 10-year U.S. Treasury note is currently fetching 0.94%. The U.S. dollar index is near steady early today on a corrective bounce after hitting 9-week low Monday. The other important outside market sees crude oil prices higher and trading around $41 a barrel. And then gets into some technical analysis here. But, you know, that's just it, folks. You know, we're kind of on a fulcrum here. We're on a between a vaccine potentially being released soon and distributed soon, and the economic reality that we're dealing with COVID and how everything handles it. It has really been bane of our existence this year. But we'll see how quickly things can turn around. You know, if they get a vaccine out, the priority is for nursing homes and areas where there are the most vulnerable among us. We'll get it first. And how long before the confidence that the public has it, general public, certainly it's going to be sometime into next year before the general public can really have any confidence that they can do things, freely, I guess you would say. According to at least some health officials, many of us feel like, you know what, we live in a threat matrix already, and as long as you are not overly, you know, subject to this thing, in other words, you're not immunocompromised, more than likely are going to be okay. The people fear it's just spreading it to the elderly and to those who are more susceptible, and I think that's generally the fear for this thing. But nonetheless, the markets react the way they do, and I believe that we are at the beginning of a recovery for gold and silver from really an unusual kind of smackdown with this news. But that's just it. It's really, in a sense, it's not unusual because you get a bit of good news like this, and it is good news to some extent for those who at least are willing to take this thing, especially if you're immunocompromised. But it's the reality of our present situation and what we've been doing. This is something that's not talked about, even in these articles that are obviously focused on precious metals. But you have what we've been doing even before the coronavirus CARES package and the quantitative easing that's occurred, the repurchase agreements, the already liquidity that's been put into the markets before the coronavirus pandemic in earlier this year, February, March of this year. So it's going to be interesting to see how this plays out. When will the realities of that situation hit home and then gold and silver climb up substantially? My guess is because most every other central bank is doing it, and we're doing it to an even greater extent, then it may be a while before that occurs. So we'll just kind of play everything by ear. And the lesson here that we can always learn from this, just like with any other issue out there, is just to be prepared. And how do you prepare? Financially, I believe, is to hold physical gold and silver in times like this, where our dollar is being debased on a daily basis and by design. So you hold gold and silver to protect yourself, especially gold is the ultimate safe haven, I believe, the ultimate store of wealth out there. So there's your news for today. Very fascinating indeed where these markets are going and where gold and prices will go from here on out. I believe it is up, at least at some level. I believe we're going to recover the losses we took yesterday and maybe even before the end of the week. But obviously, that's just my prediction. I don't have a magic ball or a crystal ball or any kind of ball except for a sphere of silver somewhere around here. I don't know where it is right now. I do have one of those, but that's it. And that doesn't tell me where the price of silver is going to go or where gold is going to go. So there you go. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Post your thoughts in the comment section below. I'd like to extend a multitude of gratitude to you all for taking the time to watch and encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.